Hi, my name is Matt Siddall. I'm one of the elite applications engineers at TriMech, and today we're going to be taking a look at creating your own custom weldment profiles. We are going to be working off a piece of imported geometry. In this case, it's a 3-inch by 1.5-inch piece of 8020, and we're also going to kind of utilize this imported geometry to show how to best optimize your Weldment profiles so that you get the most out of what you need from them without having them negatively impact your parts and assemblies, as you can end up with quite large files with more complex Weldment profiles. So step one here is going to just kind of be to pick the plane that you're going to be using. In our case, we'll be using the front plane. At this point, we're going to go ahead and sketch in our cross-sectional profile for our weldment. Because I'm working off of imported geometry, I can just use convert entities, and I can pull those inner loops with this tool as well. And then we'll go ahead and get our exterior loops, or exterior loop, I should say. And at this point, once you have this dimensioned and set up, you can start to do things like optimization. Optimization is more going to be focused on people that are working with imported sketches or imported parts if they're converting to become 8020 profiles or anything else where you're going to have something a little bit more complex that maybe you don't want to sketch out by hand. And what we're going to be doing is using the trim and extend tool. That's really one of my preferred tools for something like this, where all of these little grooves here are going to be kind of a performance hit when working with this weldment in the future, and they shouldn't really impact the overall weight of our profile that much. And by clicking and dragging, we can extend that one line out and clean up our edge. I'm going to go ahead and continue with this particular profile, and then I'll catch back up with you in a moment. Okay, coming back in, I've removed all of the grooves from the sketch profile that we're working with, and this is where it's going to start to get into kind of personal discretion as far as what other components or portions of this profile that we're going to retain and or get rid of. So because this is hollow 8020, if you are going to be utilizing the Weldments and Structure Systems tools to get total weights for your final projects, then that may be an instance where leaving these little hollow areas, either in the corners or in the central area, leaving those in your sketch profile. But if these are something that isn't going to impact what you're utilizing this for, and weight isn't something that's going to need to be calculated, then you could go ahead and remove those so that you can optimize the impact of these different profiles on your parts and assemblies down the road. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and leave them. And next thing that we'll be working on is placing our pierce points. So with weldments, we utilize points to kind of determine what is going to be the axis for our sketch lines when we replace our sketch lines with our weldment profiles. So the way we do this is we just place a variety of points throughout our part. From my perspective, I always place more sketch points than I'm probably ever going to need, but I do that because, from my perspective, I don't want to be interrupted in the middle of a design when or if I need to come back and add in additional pierce points when I'm working. So with that done, all of these underdefined points can be selected. These could be anchored and defined fully either with sketch relations or dimensions, or in my case, I'm just going to go ahead and fix all of them in place so that I don't have to worry about them. And as far as actually building the information for our weldment profile, we're basically done that at this point. The next thing is going to be actually saving this so we can access it. It's important that you select the sketch that is going to be relevant for this. Otherwise, it won't show up when you get into your library feature. It's important that you have your sketch highlighted when we go to save this. Otherwise, it isn't going to show up when we go to utilize this down the road. It needs to not only know that there is going to be a library feature part created out of this, but it needs to know what sketch exactly that you care about. So selecting our library feature part as our type of file to save will get rerouted to one of our custom file directories. In my case, I have a personally built up custom Weldments area. And then to just stay in line with the expected number of drop downs that we're going to see inside of SOLIDWORKS when we go to use our Weldments, I tend to do categorizations based on what the member type is. Then I might do something like having an inch and or metric version. And then finally, in this case, I know this is a 3 inch by 1.5 inch, so I can call this a 2 by 1. If you wanted to go and put the actual dimensions in there, you can do that. If you're like me, I tended to use a consistent 1.5 inch single unit for my 80/20. So using a 2 by 1 profile was more than enough for me to understand what I was using. And we can go ahead and save that. And then again, just to reiterate, we'll know we've succeeded in saving it correctly when the sketch in question gets a little capital L overlaying the standard sketch icon. We can go ahead and close this now and start a new part to go ahead and test this out. We can go ahead and create a sketch on our top plane. We can create a basic rectangle here. And then we can go ahead and just put some dimensions in here. So we can have this maybe be 12 foot. And then we can go ahead and maybe do 8 foot for this side. And come into our Weldments tab. We have our information here. We'll notice that we could have actually applied a general material to this, where 80/20 obviously is going to be aluminum in most cases. And we can go ahead and start applying our groups because we're going to be coming around this in a contiguous loop like this. We can always zoom in here. And if we want this to be an interior sketch, we can go ahead and use our locate profile and shift this whole thing out. We can then come into a top view and we want to have this be butted. Obviously, with 80/20, you're not going to really be mitering things. If we want our sides to be the long members, we're going to have to come in and update our corners. We can go ahead and update that. That one's correct. And then we can finalize this one. And with that, we've created our 80-20 profile. We've gone in and we've made a sketch and utilized it. There seems to be a error here with being unable to offset one or more sketch entities. This may be entirely because I've actually built out an 80-20 library, so it is seeing it in multiple locations. So I would just disregard this error. But anyway, I hope this has been helpful, and thank you for watching.